Adenomatoid odontogenic tumor is a benign tumor of odontogenic origin that is thought to arise from the remnants of the dental lamina. It represents around 2.2% to 7.1% of all odontogenic tumors and is believed to be the fourth most common odontogenic tumor. This lesion was formerly thought to be a variant of a solid multicystic ameloblastoma and was called as adenoameloblastoma. Although classified as a benign odontogenic tumor, some pathologists consider AOT to be a hamartoma, citing its limited size and lack of recurrence as a reason. However, some investigators have reported AOTs of considerable sizes and attribute the limited size of the lesion to its early detection and removal. Most AOTs occur in the second decade of life, with 53% of the lesions occurring within 13 to 19 years of age. There is a general female predilection, with at least 64% of the tumors occurring in females compared to 36% in males. Its frequency in maxilla is twice that of the mandible and has a predilection for the maxillary anteriors. It is reported that 75% or 2/3 of the cases are associated with an unerupted canine. AOT is also known to be more commonly associated with a maxillary canine than its mandibular counterpart. Now, most cases of AOT are diagnosed either during a routine radiographic examination or when radiographs are taken to determine the cause of a tooth's non-eruption. They are usually asymptomatic and vary between 1 to 3 cm in size. However, large lesions have been reported and may cause swelling of the jaws and facial asymmetry. A peripheral or a soft tissue variant of AOT has also been reported and usually occurs as a small sessile growth on the gingiva, more commonly on the maxilla than on the mandible. Radiographically, AOTs are of two types, the follicular and the extrafollicular type. The follicular type mimics the dentigerous cyst and manifests as a unilocular radiolucency associated with the crown. However, unlike the dentigerous cyst, the radiolucency often extends beyond the cemento-enamel junction and also involves the root of the tooth. The extrafollicular variant is usually a unilocular radiolucency that is associated with an erupted tooth. The radiolucency may be in close association with the apex of a tooth root, superimposed on the tooth root, may be present between the roots of adjacent teeth, or rarely may not be in association with any teeth. 2/3 of the radiolucencies, both follicular and extrafollicular types, may have radiopic flecks of calcified tissue. The lesion may cause expansion of cortical plates and displacement of adjacent teeth. Under the microscope, AOT shows sheets, strands, or whorled masses and nodules of spindle-shaped, cuboidal, or columnar cells with very little connective tissue. Now, in the midst of these cells, characteristic duct-like structures as well as rosette-like structures are present. These duct-like structures are not true ducts and are composed of low columnar cells with nuclei polarized away from the lumen. The cells surround a lumen which may or may not possess eosinophilic material. The duct-like structure sometimes possesses a rim of eosinophilic material just above the cells and around the lumen and is called as a hyaline ring. There may be droplets of eosinophilic material in the midst of these sheets or nodules of cells, and they are called tumor droplets. Also scattered throughout the lesion are foci of calcified material. There have been reports of AOT showing focal areas similar to calcifying epithelial odontogenic tumor. AOT is a benign tumor and can be treated by a conservative surgical excision and does not mandate aggressive surgery. AOT is not aggressive and seldom shows any recurrence.